Hello everybody, welcome back to ScratchForFun, and today we are back doing a little bit more modding. Today we're going to work on our model. So we are popping up with a new model thingy in our Techne. I'm just going to let's just make this a little bit smaller here so you can all see what's going on. So I want to create a new project, and then new model pops up. Okay, it also pops up when you start, if you have shown startup. Now, you can use turbo model thingy, but if you are going to use turbo model thingy, you need to download, I think. I'm not sure, but I think you need to download a mod called turbo model thingy. So yeah, just a thumbs up there. But of course, you can of course do that because, you know, when people are going to play your mod, they basically need to at least install Forge before, and then it should be very simple to install this turbo model thingy as well. So we are going to create a new normal model for this model thingy. Let's just call it something like model. It's only going to be a block for now. We're going to create a mob later. So what shall I call it, and what should we actually make? Let's make something like a trash can. It will work like a trash can if you of course want. I like to go with 64 by 64 for textures, and we're going to create. So here we go, this is now our trash can. If you remember the controls, good for you. If not, watch my last modding tutorial. Just go into go into my channel and click on videos, and you should see it very swell. So this is basically basically how it works out. We got this wooden block right here. This is just to help us out. I explained all of the controls and everything last time, so there you go. Now what we are going to do is we're going to create a trash can. So I'm not sure how you create a trash can. So this is going to be a little bit of a new thing for me too. Now let's first of all start by creating the bottom of the trash can. So let's move this down a little bit. How big do we want this? Let's first of all get it down at the on top of the wooden block. There we go. And then we can start leveling it out. So let's move this one. How big do we want it? Like four pixels, I think, is a good number. There we go, and let's do the same here. So we got 4 pixels of space. You know, you can of course create whatever you like. This is just me creating a trash can right here. So what should we add to our trash can now? There's 4 pixels on each side. Now let's add another block. Here we go, a new block. Let's bring it down a little bit so it's easier to see. Now let's add a wall kind of thingy, shall we? Let's make this wall a little bit higher. Yeah, that's good, I guess. maybe one more. Two more. No, one more. There we go. Now we're going to move this one over to this side right here. Now we are actually going to have it down into the block right here. Now I'm not sure if that's, I don't think that's a very smart thing to do. Now we want to rotate this thingy right here. So the way we're going to rotate it is, if I just try to rotate right now, it will rotate around the top here. That's not a thing basically that we want. So what we're going to do is we're going to move this blue ball down, first of all. So let's move the blue ball down to where we want to rotate it around. Then we go off with the offset down here. And we can move this one. Where do we want it? Want it down into the ground here, I think. Let's actually just move it a little bit over. No, not that one. One too much. Now let's just move it over here, and let's make it over here, and then let's basically extend it out in width here, and then we're going to kind of rotate it. That's not the right way. This right here. Then Now we don't want to rotate it too much, or else it will look very, very weird. Let's just go for that. That's a nice number. Let's actually go for 8, I think. Now, it might look a little bit weird down here, so you should basically make sure that this is, how you want it. So yeah, I think that's pretty good. Let's create some more sides here. Now, you should not use copy-paste, because that will make these have the same name, and that will give us errors. So we are going to create another one from scratch, basically. 8 in width, and let's move it down. Down to here. And let's move it along. Oh, one more. And let's move it up over here. And let's basically extend the height, and let's first of all get this one level there, using the offset and position here, and let's bring that one down there. Beautiful. Now let's rotate it. We're going to rotate it -8, and there you go. That's basically the start of your trash can. Now we can of course just add pixels to make it look kind of round, but I like this. And then we are going to create another box. If I were to click this copy paste, you can see I now got two objects called shape 3. Of course I can just, you know, rename this to shape 4. That would of course do the trick. But if any of these have the exact same name, you're going to get an error. Now let's just go like this. 90 degrees, hopefully that's the correct one. No, it was not. 0, this one, 90 degrees. Nope. All I want to do, -90. Ah, well, let's just go with that. It's actually upside down. Does that have anything to say? Let's move it offset. Let's get that blue ball down there, I guess, so it rotates around that. Oh, no, that's not down. Let's get it over there. Let's move it down. And let's... oh, snap. Of course, we could have made something more exciting than a trash can. Of course, but yeah, I am a exciting person. Oh, that's not what we want. We want a blue ball to be one higher, I think. So let's move it one more up, and let's move the offset down. Now this does look very weird, as this one looks like it kind of bulks out here. What's the dealio with that? What? I'll have a look. Okay, let's not care about that. Hopefully it looks better in game. We can probably just copy and paste this one though. Copy paste, make sure you got it selected. Now make sure you change the name, or else you are going to have a problem. Now this ball resets, I think all the positions resets, though the width and rotation and everything like that stays the same. Now we are going to rotate this one -90 degrees. We are going to offset our ball a little bit. By that much, no, that's one too much, I think. There we go, and let's move it down. Let's see here, a little bit more down. There we go, let's move it off here, and off here, wrong way. There we go. So that's basically a kind of simple trash can, I guess. Now we could of course add something to the edges here. We might do that as well. Now I'm not very good at doing stuff like this, basically, as you can probably tell. I'm not a modeler, so you do this however you want to do this. I've never 3D modeled anything in my life. I've done a few animations, 3D animations, but that's not modeling, basically. That's kind of, I know exactly how it's going to look, and I do it. I do not create stuff. Create models, I use models. So let's add another one of these. I think let's add a few stripes, kind of. Now let's move this one down. Let's first of all get this one. What's the height? 11, okay, that's nice. Let's get this one going down. Let's have a look from this side here. One more. There we go. I think at least. There we go. 23. Okay, now we are going to move this one off. Off here. Oh, wrong way again. And then off here. Now, this does not look very, very good. One more off. I guess. Now, how do we want to do this right here? We can probably rotate it a little bit. Let's try. Nope. Let's zero that one. Yes, here we go. We are going to set this one to 45 degrees. Now, this ball is not. The ball basically needs to stay a place. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to move the ball down into the middle here. Oh, my controls are inverted. When you zoom in enough, your controls get inverted. So let's offset this one a little bit. Oh, wrong way. Now, how do we want to do this? Now, we want to move it out, the blue ball out here. So we basically offset it. I did not mean to do that. I did mean to do that. How do you do this? Let's first of all move this one over one. There we go. And then we can probably offset this by a half. X is probably around here. Let's say minus 1.5. You need to write it, I think. That's the wrong way. Zero. Nope, we want it to be minus 1 here. And then we want it to be 0.5 here, I think. Minus 0.5. Minus 0.5. There we go. And then we're going to move it down a little bit more. Down. Nope, one too much. There we go. Now, we probably want to rotate it a little bit more. Because right now it looks a little bit shitty. So let's rotate. Let's actually move this one. Let's offset it one less, I think. There we go, and let's move this one more in. There we go, that's one more in. And then we are going to rotate it a little bit. So, that's not the way I want to rotate it. The other way. Minus 8, I think. That looks ugly. Very ugly. Yeah, I think we'll drop that one. But yeah, if you want anything more to your trash can or whatever you're creating, just do it. Now, or to the textures files, we want to export as a texture map. We're going to just export it down. Oh, that's loud. At our desktop. There we go. Sound down a little bit. Let's open up our paint.net using Windows 8. Oh, it's beautiful. You need to get yourself Windows 8 if you do not have it already. It's incredible. So let's open up our model. There we go. So this is basically our model. I forgot to offset stuff here. We need to offset the textures. Now I think all of these sides are going to have the same textures, all of these four sides here. Of course, if you do not want to, you do not need to, but let's get to the bottom shape here. It is not going, so there's something else, something here called texture offset. So what I'm basically going to do is I'm going to move this one off a little bit, so this texture right here is not basically interfering with all of these textures right here, because these are basically going to be the same. Then we're going to export as a texture map. I'm just going to save it, sound a lot better now, and let us open up our model and let's do some stuff here. Okay, so this is basically the bottom top and a bottom face. How do we want the top to look? Let's first of all select this area. Just so we do not draw outside of it, let's fill it in with a little bit of gray. Of course, if you do not want to watch me create my textures, you do not need to, but if you want to, you can, of course. We're going to make it a little darker again. I think that's a nice texture. It's not very much, but it is gray. Let's make the same texture for the bottom, I guess. There we go. So the top and the bottom has the same texture. The sides here are going to basically have... Let's just be lazy and copy over here. Yeah. And let's do the same for all of these sides as well, because we are all lazy people, or I am at least. Hopefully you are not that lazy. Now we are also going to create this right here. This is the top texture. How is that going to look? We can probably just copy this right here. This is the top texture for this mosaic right here. Let's actually not do that. We can rather... Let's create the left side, okay? Left side, that's the red rectangle over here. Let's grab, let's fill this one with a nice color. Let's grab this color right here and let's brush a little bit here. And let's grab the, you know, the little bit darker color again. And there you go, a nice texture. Over to the red square over here. Let's copy this texture over here, I guess, and then let's just do that, I guess. Why not? And then these two are the top and the bottom, I think. So what do we want to do for the top? The top. We can probably... Let's just do it the nice way. Let's just grab all of these pixels here. Number four. There we go. Let's copy this over to the bottom side. Because people cannot look at the top and the bottom at the same time, so it doesn't matter really, in my opinion. Of course, I'm a little bit lazy, so yeah. let's just hit file and let's hit save. And let's go into our Techne again. And let's you click this load texture button and let's hit model. And there you go. This is basically how your trash can is going to look in the game. I think it looks pretty darn awesome, in my opinion at least. It has the same texture on all the sides. If you do not want that, you can offset the textures for these squares here as well, the same way we offsetted the texture of shape 1. So this right here is going to have a different texture than everything else, basically. Now, I do know how to do this already, so I'm going to open this up in the game, and we're going to look, basically have a look on this model in the game. Okay, So this is how it looks in Minecraft. I can basically place it down. Now it does not look how I wanted it to look. The texture is fine, but we have rotated the wrong angles on two of them. Now that is not something we want, of course. So what did we do wrong? It looks very, very fine. Now I think that those that's basically, you know, that we got a little bit of problems on. Now this is not a problem, you know, from us. This is probably a Techne, which is, you know, something done something that should not be done. Of course, I do not know. But yeah, now we should probably not rotate two of them at the same time. So I'll fix it up. It should look exactly the same though, just not rotate it, just having this on 8 instead. Basically something like this. And then 0. So yeah, I'll fix it. Okay, so now fixed the model, I believe at least. Now the only thing, only problem here is some of these textures are kind of see-through, which is not exactly very, very good. So we're going to fix that. The way we're going to fix that is, I think this is backwards. Well, I'm not sure. But the way we're going to fix this is, of course, now we have these two have the same texture. Now these two have different textures once more. So we're basically going to move these up here. Let's move them a little bit sideways. There we go. And let's move this one as well. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to move the texture offset. Now it's going to be the same position basically as the one under here. There we go. Now all we need to do is we need to update these textures. I'll do so as well. Let's just do it on camera here. Now let's see here. Okay, so we got the top and the bottom, it looks like. That's not what we wanted. This is pixel free. Then we have our top here. That is, I can't remember, but is it, I think it is this line right here. Oh. And then we're going to paste this over here. And then we're going to, I'll have a look. Textures complete. Let's close this off once more. Does it automatically update? No, not of course not. The code does not automatically update. So I'll update the code as well. Okay, so here we are. The thingy does now look exactly how it looked on the screen here. As you can see here, you know, it's the same in Minecraft and in the other one. It has a texture down at the bottom here, and it has a texture, you know, if we look from down under here. Now it does look a little bit weird from under here, of course. That's stuff we can smooth off, of course. I will probably not do that. For me it does not, you know, I do not care very much how this looks. But yeah, that's basically the trash can. Now of course I've not shown you how you can do this, so yeah. I'm going to teach you in due course how to create this, basically this block right here. We're going to do some more stuff that I've done right now. I've just added it quickly basically. So yeah, thanks so much for watching everybody. If you want to learn how to do this and dimensions, as I'm going to start up very, very, very quickly now. If you want to learn that, make sure to subscribe to my channel, as I will do my best to cover all of the necessary stuff to be an awesome modder. So yeah, thanks so much for watching everybody. My name is ScratchFun, and I'll catch you all guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.